Hello dear Capricorn, that will be an astrological forecast for you for 2021 July. The first thing that you will feel from June when Neptune turned retrograde in your third house, so it is it's helped to stop dream too much, a bit you know, bring you more reality for your life. And definitely if you are planning to be a self-employer or you are planning to do your own plans, this is really the time when you can see a bit more clearly. In July, the first aspect what we will have, it's an opposition which will be in your 8th and 2nd house between Mars and Saturn. This could bring you hidden problems, and I would say that definitely in financial areas. So maybe one of your investment is not that good, or you could lose money, especially if you have investment. I would think about like Bitcoin. Also, with properties, it could bring you problems, or somehow you will see that you spend more money than how much you should or would, and maybe your credit cards will be a bit, you know, I would say like overcharged, or you overspend in this time, and or you did already some overspending, and this time you have to face with this problem. On 3rd of July, we will have a square which will be between Uranus and Mars, which is your 8th and 6th house. In this time, you should really be careful. Unexpected things could happen, and I would say that unexpected injuries, or you could lose easily things, but you really have to care about what you do in your workplace. And so you could have affairs or injuries in your workplace, definitely. Also, you need to see that how maybe your work could affect for your health very unexpectedly. On 5th of July, we will have the Sun and the Uranus sextile. It is your 8th and 5th house. I would say that it could bring you unexpected changes in some areas, like if you have a child, maybe unexpected changes are coming with your child. If you are planning, or even if you're not planning to have a baby, here changes could come in. Sadly, you can, if you have a baby, maybe you your pregnancy will not go on the right way, or you just can get pregnant unexpectedly, even if you didn't want to. On 6th of July, Mercury and Neptune will make a square, which is your 6th and your 3rd house. It is the time when you could have some communication issues, and these issues could happening in your workplace, but also if you have a consultation about your health condition with doctors, you need to really care about the information what you get and what you give. Also, in these two areas, maybe you could have a very intense and rapid changes or decisions. 6th of July, Venus and Saturn make an opposition. It is your 8th and 2nd house again. Yeah, it is the time when you want to make fun, you want to spend money, but you need to be careful, and you need to care about that, how much you spend. Yeah, that's a funny day, that how can you be responsible and how can you make fun at the same time. On July of 8th of July, we will have a square between Venus 8th house and Uranus 5th house. That could bring you unexpected changes in, but definitely in some way, maybe it could be a positive change as well in financial ways or investment area. Somehow, what makes you happy can be an investment, but also you could have problems in these areas, and you could have problems with financial problems can coming from your family, like a children. Or maybe you will need to spend more for your child. Also, that could be the time when you could have problems if you have a lover, and maybe you need to make a decision that it still be just fun, or you go a step further. On 9th of July, we will have a new moon, which will be in your 7th house. It is an extra strong new moon, so it is in your seventh house. So if you are a self-employer or you work with a lot of partner, you really these things will be your topic, and also your relationship. But this is not the time for action, so it is not the time, and I would say that, oh yeah, you have to start or you could start a new relationship, you should or could find new partners. This is the time when you need to listen for your feelings and for your soul, because it is not the time for action. On 11th of July, Mercury will entering your seventh house. It's interesting because you could be easily manipulated in your relationship area, but also you will be super sensitive on these days. So what I would say, if you have an argument or you will feel something that hurting you, don't get that too serious, because you are just over sensitive on this day. 12th of July, you will have an aspect between Jupiter and Mercury. It will be in your 3rd and 7th house. It's a perfect day if you are a self-employer. It's a perfect day for find new partners or make plans for how can you grow. And also, if you are single, or even if you are not, and maybe you have a conflict in your relationship, it is a beautiful day and a perfect day for conflicts, to discuss about conflicts. And if you're looking for relationship, it is the day when you maybe could make the first step. So you could send this message, you can call that guy or girl. It's a good day. On 15th of July, we will have a trine between Neptune and Sun, which is again your seventh house, so good. It is also a good aspect when you will feel okay, you will feel confident. So it brings you a lot of good energies, even in your relationship area and even in studies and communication area. Also, on 15th of July, Chiron will turn to retrograde. It will be in your 4th house. If you have any family issue, any conversation or problem, or somehow something goes wrong in your family life, that will be the time when you could find solutions for your problems, and you can be your own healer. On 15th and 17th of July, Sun and Pluto will make an opposition. That is a very strong aspect. It could be a great time, but also a bad time too. It is the time when you could be jealous, and if you show it and you act like a jealous guy or girl, that could be a nightmare. If you could keep your bad feelings inside of you and not listening for these feelings, then it could be a wonderful day. On 20th of July, Mercury and Uranus will make a sextile. It's quite interesting. I would say, because it's your 5th and 7th house, and both talks about love life or relationship, maybe if you have a lover or just a, I would say, like a sexual relationship, this could change. Maybe it could go a higher level. Maybe it could turn to a relationship. But these love life, sexual life, and the relationship topics will be quite important on this day, and very unexpected changes can coming on this day. On 21st of July, we will have Venus in your ninth house. That is the time when you are maybe planning to make a journey for another country, or you are planning to learn something new. But you want to make fun, you want to take a lot, but somehow you need to be a bit more critical and looking for how much money you spend. So it's a funny day, but by the way, it's a perfect day for shining and have fun. On 22nd of July, Sun will entering your eighth house. It's not a bad day, but in eighth house it could bring you hidden topics. So somehow things what is hidden in your life and you didn't care about will come up. And you need to take care of these topics, or you need to make an action, but you could do it very nicely, so not that much drama we are coming. Also on 22nd of July, Venus and Jupiter will make an opposition. I would say that you will feel a bit free, like you will feel like that, okay, I'm free now. Maybe you will have an exam, but more likely I would say that you can open your mind and you can learn easily, you can do everything easily, your communication will be easier. Somehow the success is coming for you on these days, so you can grow a lot, even if it's an opposition. On 23rd of July, we will have a full moon in your second house. Somehow you need to listen for your inner voice, because some of your talent, which is not used quite often, maybe will be or could be useful for you. You just need to listen for yourself, that what is inside of you. On 24th of July, Mercury and Neptune will make a trine, which will be your seventh and third house. So this day is it's an important day, because you could be very intense on this day, and definitely in communication area and communication in relationship or any kind of partnership, like in your work partners. Be careful, because you will be super sensitive. You will feel like that you will be too sensitive. It will be an easy day to hurt you, but it is just you. You shouldn't get serious all the things around you. On 25th of July, the next day, we will have an opposition between Mercury and Pluto. This is not a good aspect, and this is the day when you could say things which is not nice, and which words can be in your life maybe forever. So be careful what you say and for who. Definitely in your relationship and partnership ship areas. On 28, oh no, 28th of July, Jupiter will entering again, so moving back to Aquarius. That's a chance for us, because it will bring back for you topics which has been in your life in the middle of May. And you can get ready for the next year. We will have a chance to get ready for the next year again. So these topics, which has been here in May, will be revisited. And now Jupiter give us a chance to learn from it and maybe developing. On 29th of July, the last aspect, Mars will entering your ninth house, actually Virgo. That is the time when we could be more organized. If you are a teacher, you can teach easier. If you are a student, you can learn easier. But somehow everything will be more organized. Everybody will be more helpful with you, and you could be more helpful than how helpful you used to be. Thank you for watching my video. If you like it, please subscribe for my channel. Then you can see my next month forecast as well. Thank you for watching my video.